What was your first climb like?
The first time, I didn't make it, but I kept pursuing my dream. My college thesis was about volcanic gases, so I kept pursuing my dream.
So Arlene, tell us about your 1978 climb in Nepal.
Well, I was a leader of an all-women group to climb a mountain in Nepal. Only 8 people have climbed it before. They were all men.
Arlene, what was your longest journey?
Well, the longest would probably be the 2,000-mile trek from India to France, which I carried my baby in my backpack the whole time.
How have you impacted the world around you?
Well, I discovered a chemical in children's pajamas to keep them from catching on fire. It causes cancer. So, in 2007, I brought safer standards to the world and taught them about toxic chemicals.
What motivates you to do this?
My beloved mountains. I wanted to educate people about global warming by teaching them about toxic chemicals.
Arlene, how do you survive in these horrendous conditions?
Well, I use some boards that I find, and I use the tree bark that I find, and make shelters and survive under to save myself from the snow.
Arlene, what is your morning routine before a climb?
In the morning, I like to have coffee because it helps me wake up and stay active. I have 3 cups of coffee each day. In the mornings, I also like to have Raisin Bran. It helps me stay active and sunny all day. It has vitamins and minerals and whole grain wheat. Before I start going on a big trail, I like to practice, like on such as page 12 of the Iron Goat Trail, which I practice carrying my baby on my back. I practice this 3 times and I walk backwards up it once. Before I leave, I like to have good hygiene. I like to stay healthy and use Listerine. It keeps my mouth fresh and my breath clean.
Arlene, how do you protect yourself when you're on these remote trails out in the wilderness?
In my trails, I like to keep weapons, such as pistols, M4s,